What can I do for you guys?
We own a brewery right up the street, DC Brau Brewing, and we're about 3 years old.
You guys make your own beer?
That is correct. Jeff and I were born and raised here in Washington, D.C. We grew up in the city, and we decided that, hey, we should probably do something crazy, like open a brewery together.
It was the first brewery in D.C. in 60 years. We've expanded twice since then. We're looking to expand the reach. That's kind of why we're here, looking to expand the brand presence.
We were hoping you had sort of like a beater that we could turn the back of it into like a mobile keg box and just drive this thing right up to all the beer festivals we do. Just pour beer right out of the side for everybody.
Roughly, what would your budget be on something like that?
15K?
I think we can swing about 15K, yeah.
We can find a beater. Getting it ready for you guys to take somewhere is the most expensive part. I look at these guys, they're a small local business, just the way I started. So I'd like to help them get off the ground. Andrew, the same way I helped Andrew get going. Got a couple of guys out here want a car on the road with a refrigeration compartment in the back for kegs.
My old man comes in with the project. Right away, it sets off alarm bells.
They go to all of these festivals. Might be some good advertising. Come on, I know you're tired. Andy's not interested unless he's seeing a big dollar sign. But I think it'll be a great way to get our name out there.
So what you guys are gonna see out here is obviously stuff that we're crushing, but just get an idea for the size of the vehicle. Do you want an older vehicle? Do you want a newer vehicle? How reliable do you want it to be?
It's gonna have to have a significant amount of space in the back,
right,
so that we can outfit that keg apparatus back there, so we'll be able to pour right out of the truck.
How many kegs do you want?
4 to 6.
Yeah, 4 to 6.
365 8-ounce glass beers in a keg.
It's a little bit less than that.
It used to be when I was pulling. Give him a little head.
My dad poured a couple of beers 36 years ago, and now he thinks he's an expert?
You guys could always grab a Suburban like this. I don't know if we could get 6 in there, but you might be able to figure out how to get 4 in, right, Andrew?
Well, the problem's gonna be is we're gonna have to do something to keep up the weight. Obviously, it's gonna be a refrigeration unit, so that's gonna weigh quite a bit. You're gonna need something to power the refrigeration unit. Then we're gonna have to see how many we can actually fit in the thing.
These guys want too much for too little. I'm looking at this deal, and it doesn't make any sense. If my dad wants to help the neighborhood kids, he can do it on his own time and his own dime.
Andrew.
Yeah?
We're in trouble.
That doesn't surprise me at all.
Seriously, we've got to find this truck. And I mean, we got to find it yesterday.
That was your gig, not my gig.
Well, I need your help in finding the truck.
Surprise, surprise, my dad can't find the right truck. It's probably because he's looking in the yellow pages.
You're not gonna buy anything decent for the budget that you're in.
I gotta leave it on you.
It ain't on me, it's on you.
No, it's on Tommy.
I mean, the longer we wait on getting this truck, the more it's on my shoulders. We already were supposed to have the truck last week.
At the end of the day, if I don't step in, nobody's leaving happy.
And that's why I'm looking. I'll try and find you
something. All right, there we go.
My strategy has always been, when in doubt, go big, take the risk. If we're gonna do this at all, we're gonna do it my way, the right way.
Bob, what are you doing?
Nothing.
Come on outside, got a surprise for you.
What kind of surprise?
Come on.
You know what a surprise is to me?
Yeah.
That's a fart with humps in it. That's a surprise.
Helping you out, Bob.
Ooh, that looks great, Andrew.
Like that?
Yes, I do.
Chrome wheels?
Yes.
White paint? You can't get any better than this.
Man, I'm gonna tell you, Andrew, you did good this time. With Andrew, you gotta let him think it's his idea. Plant the seed, water it, and let it grow. We're ready to turn the box truck into a brew pub on wheels. Luckily, DC Brau works with their own guys at AC Beverage. He's gonna put taps and refrigeration in to showcase his own work.
We've probably got about 40 man hours plus right now.
The main part of the truck is gonna be a refrigeration unit. We're gonna be able to fit in 16 kegs. The lines are gonna run through a backup chiller that they can fill with ice if the refrigeration fails. Then they're gonna connect the 8 taps on the outside of the truck.
Built the entire cooler section out, completely insulated with 2-inch foam board. It's framed out with pressure treated lumber. Right here is our nitrogenator mixed gas system. We're going to be able to supply all the gas necessary for the beer. they run short on gas, it could be the end of the beer. So we tend to believe in having onboard gas supplies if at all possible. So what we're going to do is create a stainless box we're going to insert into the side of the truck for our inserted shadow box.
AC Beverage got the beer system in place, and now I have to install the racks to keep the kegs from sliding around. I also have to build a door for the back of the refrigeration system. We have to install the generator, and we have to make sure everything's properly ventilated back there. A lot of work, but we'll get it done. T2 is one of our newest techs. He's like a fabricator, an electrician, and an artist, all rolled into one. I grabbed him to be my second on this project, and he's just banging out the details, one right after the other. Oh yeah, that looks good, man.
Just gotta button it up a little bit and final mount these.
I mean, it's kind of hard to see with the light right now, but at night, this thing will be changing colors like crazy and reflecting off of all the stainless. Jeff, what do you got left, brother? All right, look at that. We got a freezer door.
Cool. Shut flat, getting ready to mount the latch on it, and this part's done.
Well, I'm gonna need to get some help here in a few minutes putting the roof piece on. The one big addition the DC Brau guys wanted on this truck is they wanted to add a DJ booth so that way they could stand out at festivals, play music. I think it's a really cool addition. There's no good spot on the inside of this truck to put this DJ booth, so I'm gonna stick it on the roof.
Put together a wrap to make it look like where they brew the beer. A little bit of a three-dimensional look to it. I think our biggest challenge is gonna be this back door. We're gonna go ahead and cover up the windows because they're not using the windows anyways. Going over top of the hinges create a little bit of a problem because the vinyl doesn't want to stretch all the way around that. We're gonna have to stretch as far as it goes and then we'll cut the rest of it in. And after we get done putting this panel on, we're gonna bring the other panel on, and that's what's so critical. We can't overstretch this side, and then all of a sudden, our panel's not gonna line up down there. We get one shot at this, and we could peel this back up, but I don't wanna start all from scratch again, so we just gotta take our time and make sure everything falls in the correct spot.
All right, let's do this.
All the kegs are tapped, everything's ready to go, everything's cold. AC Beverage just showed up to start checking stuff out. Jackson Audio just got here, he set their stuff off. Crowd's already here, pressure's on.
What could go wrong? Besides everything.
Let's not worry about that. Let's just go get them.
Okay.
You guys ready? All right, here we go. You guys excited? What do you think?
God, man, I haven't seen it since the initial planning phase of
it,
so.
I feel like this has been a culmination of a lot of efforts. I'm really excited to see
man.
It.
A lot of people came together to make this thing happen. I think you guys are gonna be really excited about it. All right, I'm gonna count it down. Woo! 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. These guys had some pretty big expectations. I just wanted to make sure we could meet it.
I think we pulled it off.
We definitely pulled it off. AC Beverage, you guys want to do the honors?
Wow. So this is right off the cellar stream.
This is right off the cellar stream. You've got a nitro beer being poured, and from the same keg, we can pour the same beer in a carbonated version.
One nitro, one CO2.
There you go, same beer.
Sure.
Cheers.
Let's cheers. Lightly, no break.
This is beyond what we had in mind, though. This is way beyond what we had in mind. This is incredible.
Oh! Lorenzi. Got all of our partners here that helped with the build. And this is where it all happens. We have the freezer, the generators.
We've got a nitrogenator right on the truck?
Right on the truck.
Woo-hoo!
We've got the nitrogenator on-site gas system. You don't have to worry about hauling all the tanks of gas around.
So that pulls it right out of the air.
Right out of the air. You're making your own nitrogen.
Yeah, man, it's all here.
A statement about our brand, how much we care about our product, and how much we care about our presentation.
Yeah, just to have something that's both passionate to us, you know, and functional, and is a party on wheels.
I think we'll definitely be the center of attention wherever we go. Just something I'm okay with.
Getting down with our bad selves.